Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jacintah Nyokabi Njenga from Kenya. Last year, July, I felt some discomfort in the chest, tightness, hoarseness of voice, and I went to the hospital. And I had this persistent cough that had lasted for two weeks. The doctor there advised me to take a chest x-ray, which was followed by a CT scan. It was later I realized that I had a lymphoma in my chest. In my country, they were not very specific on the kind of lymphoma that I had. But then I met a friend, a very close friend of mine, who told me that her auntie had come to this hospital in Bangui, and she advised us to come here. After a very short time, we discussed it with my husband, who is very loving and caring, and thought the idea of coming to India was the best. We traveled to India in August 2017, and we were received very well at the airport. It was our first time to come to India, but the international relations officer who received us made us feel so comfortable. We didn't feel lost. We came to the hospital and under Dr. Anthony Pius, who had invited us, but later introduced us to Harry Minon, Dr. Harry Minon, who has been a wonderful, wonderful doctor to us. He was able to do more tests, which lasted around 10 days, and he gave us hope. He told us that actually the kind of diagnosis that I had hope that I could get cured. We asked him about the percentage, and he told us, actually up to 97%, Jacintah, you will get well. These were the best news we had received since when I got this diagnosis. So we agreed to continue with the treatment, and the treatment was so different from what I had first received in Kenya. I had done a chemo for a day that was a bit comprehensive without specification. But when I came here, he told me, no, this is the protocol that we are going to use, and it is best and updated up to now. We agreed. So I did the chemo here, but also bought some drugs and went back to Kenya. He is not a selfish doctor. And one thing I would like to say, he was able to contact the doctor in Kenya and share his protocol with him. And therefore, I was able to continue with the treatment there, them liaising together, communicating together, sharing ideas, and eventually, I finished the chemo treatment. With his advice, he had said, after treatment, I come back here to see how I was progressing. So we organized and came this week for review, and we are so grateful to God and to everyone because my PET scan results were completely clean and negative. I would like to encourage everyone, if possible, Cytecare has the best specialists. Everyone that you meet in the corridors, everywhere, when you're seated, they will ask you questions about your, well, about how are you, Jacintah? Have you taken your breakfast? How do you find the stay here? And I would like to extemporarily thank one department, which is in international relations, because they've been very kind to pick us at the airport, to make sure that our stay is comfortable here. And even the nurses, everyone, every part of the staff, including the support staff, they are wonderful, wonderful people. My recommendation would be that for specification purposes, don't be treated wholesomely. Let's attack cancer the right way by finding the right doctors. Because if it was probably other countries, Dr. Pais would have taken over to treat us, but sent us to a hematospecialist. Unlike what many other doctors do, they will just treat you, probably mess you up later. But here, he did recommend and send us to the right doctor. So I'm quite grateful that I've come out of Cytecare with a cancer-free feeling. It's the best feeling that I've gotten in the last 8 months. So I'm grateful to everyone, and I will not hesitate to tell people to recommend. Actually, so far I've sent a patient here because of the experience that I've had here. Yes, thank you so much.